I often tell people that maintaining good mental health is more about what you need to do and not what you want to do, but that does not change the fact that my brain is chemically imbalanced, and that really, really upsets me. What is up, everybody? This is Chris from The Rewired Soul, where we talk about the problem, but focus on the solution. And right now when you're watching this, like today is a day when I'm doing an all day mental health Twitch live stream. So I don't know what you're doing. You should be over there right now. But if you're watching this later, go follow me on Twitch, because I love getting to talk to all of you in a one-on-one type of setting. And we have a great community already on Twitch where like people are like helping each other out and supporting each other. It is, oh, such a beautiful thing. Anyways, go follow me on Twitch. It's down in the description below. Like, watch me on your computer or your tablet or your phone or whatever it is, because I'm doing a lot more live streams, like whether I'm editing content or I'm just playing video games and talking to all of you as well. But anyways, so those of you who have been following my channel, I just made a video the other day about how I ran out of my anxiety meds and the things I was gonna do over the weekend. And like, this is something that, you know, I wanna update you guys on, but I also wanna talk to you about something I know a lot of people experience. Like, a lot of people do not want to take their mental health medications. I get that. I am in your boat. So basically, going into this weekend, like, I was prepared for the anxiety to come, all right? I was prepared, but I wasn't prepared for the depression. So about 6 years ago, when I first got sober, I was diagnosed with a generalized anxiety disorder, but I was also diagnosed with like minor depression. So my main issue was anxiety, but I also experienced depression, all right? Depression for me is a lot of feelings of like numbness, not feeling emotions, not feeling joy and everything. And that's one of the reasons why I turned to substances, which only made things worse. But anyways, like I said, I was totally prepared for the anxiety to come over the weekend. And like, I had everything planned out. I was gonna, you know, I was gonna be meditating. I was gonna be very mindful. I was gonna communicate with my girlfriend and my son and all sorts of stuff. But I wasn't prepared for the depression. And first and foremost, I wanna thank you, the viewer out there. Like you guys help me. You guys help me with my mental health. Like, sometimes like my ego wants to come into play. Like, when you guys give me suggestions in the comments, I'm like, yo, how about you wait a second? I'm the guy who's supposed to be helping you. But, you know, I gotta calm that ego, that voice in my head down, because one of you actually gave me an amazing suggestion. I'm gonna talk more in depth about this in a second. You said like, why don't you call your pharmacy? My pharmacy will give me some emergency meds, you know, if I ran out. So I'm like, okay, cool. And like, I took their advice, I called, and they were able to restock them. Well, basically they gave me three until I could follow up with my doctor today. And man, like, so, Saturday, I go to pick up my girlfriend, and like, everything was going great in the morning. I was fine, I was totally good, like no anxiety, no depression or anything like that. And I don't know what it was, like I started feeling depressed. I started feeling numb, I started feeling meh, I started feeling like no emotion. Like, I love picking up my girlfriend, she lives across town and we have great conversations, like when we pick up, because we're texting all the time, but it's great to be in the car with her and talk. And like, I just noticed like, just the depression setting in, and it was bugging me. I'm like, oh my God. And that's actually when I got home, and like, I actually recorded some videos, and like, I felt like I wasn't giving my all in the videos just because I felt depressed. Like, I made a video about H3H3 doing an update about his depression. Like, I get it, I get it. Like, I didn't wanna create, because I make these videos when I'm feeling passionate, and a lot of times I feel really passionate. I'm like, you know, my emotion, my character can come into these videos. And like, I forgot which video it was I recorded the other day, but I was just feeling like, ugh, like off. And, you know, afterwards I called up the pharmacy based on your lovely suggestions, and I called them up and I said, yeah, we can, you know, give you some until you can call your doctor. And so I go down to the pharmacy and I go and pick up my medications and I take it. And after, you know, whatever the pill, you know, I'm on Lexapro. I take the generic, it's called escitalopram. And like, after it did whatever it does in my body and metabolizes and all that, I just felt so much better. I felt so much better. And I was talking to my girlfriend, I'm like, man, I hate my medications. I hate it, like, I hate it because, and here's the thing, like, and this is again, this is ego. This is all ego. Like, I know my ego's coming into play when words like should come into my mind a lot, should or shouldn't, right? because these are based on expectations. I correlate my expectations with my ego. And like my brain is telling me like, Chris, you do all these things for your mental health. You shouldn't need these medications. You should not need these medications. Like you exercise, you meditate, you live like a very good life. You set boundaries with people. You don't keep talking to people. Like I do pretty much all of the right things, but I still need these medications or I get depressed and I get anxious. And that bugs me, it bugs me. And like, I wanted to make this video because I know so many people don't like taking their medications, but like I mentioned at the beginning of this video, mental health, maintaining our mental health is about doing what we need to do and not what we want to do. So I get it, like I don't like taking my medications either. Like, you know, I'm one of those people where, you know, maybe, and that's partially pride, right? I wanna be the guy. I wanna be the guy who doesn't need to take any medications to feel well. But the reality is that, man, like, I need them. I need them or my brain gets out of whack. I am somebody who has, you know, these mental health issues, and thank God for medical science, and it can help me out. Like, I've done a ton of research and stuff, and anti-anxiety and antidepressant medications, they don't actually do that much, but for most of us, they get us to this baseline. Like, they're not a happy pill, but they get you to this baseline. And it's like, you know, I get these fears in my mind, like, am I just gonna be this way forever? But, like, I gotta balance it out, like, what's the worst? What's the worst? Oh no, I gotta take a medication for the rest of my life, you know what I mean? So, like, if you can relate to this, like, just take some of my suggestions, like things that I do. Like, I have to recognize my ego's coming out to play. Like, for me, my mental health is extremely important because I am an addict and alcoholic in recovery, right? I'm a drug addict, I'm an alcoholic who is in recovery from addiction, and if I don't keep this thing on straight, I might relapse. And that's a big problem, you know what I mean? So it's easier for me to say, all right, Chris, shut up and just take a Lexapro. You know, I can do that because if not, I get all out of whack, you know, and I'm one step closer to relapse. So like, that's how I make sure that I stay on it. So like, if any of you could relate to this, like just, man, take your medications. I beat into the heads of my clients all the time. Like my girlfriend, when I was telling her, like she was laughing, you know, cause I was explaining this to her, you know? And she's like, yeah, but you tell everybody else to take their medications. I'm like, I know, but I can relate to the reasons why they don't want to. But anyways, I want to touch on calling the pharmacy to see if they can give me some of my medication. So like, I felt dumb. Like when it was suggested to me that I call them, like it never even crossed my mind. But I think it's, you know, it shows how far along I've come in my recovery, because my substance of choice was prescription drugs. So I was always trying to do shady stuff and call pharmacies and doctors to get my medications, you know what I mean? Because I was a drug addict, you know? So it didn't even cross my mind to call these people. I'm like, you know what, Chris, you're doing good in your recovery. Because I'm afraid of like, if I call, they're gonna be like, oh, this is some drug addict just seeking medications and, you know, whatever. But like, I just called up the pharmacy and they had no problem. They had no problem at all. They're like, yeah, we'll give you three and then call your doctor and, you know, do your thing. I'm like, oh, you know, I'm like getting all paranoid, like, are they gonna flag me in the system? Am I gonna go to the pharmacy and they're gonna have like cops waiting for me? But the medication I'm on is a non-narcotic, so it's like, it wasn't even a big deal. So today on my live stream, like I have a ton of stuff to do. So I wrote down a to-do list and one of them was to call my doctor. So an update on my medications. I have a doctor's appointment tomorrow morning, and maybe I'll do an update on this too. But I'm gonna see my doctor tomorrow because the Lexapro, it helps me immensely, but there's some side effects and things like that that I'm not cool with. I've been on this medication off and on for 6 years. And basically I'm gonna have a conversation with my doctor. I have an amazing, amazing doctor. And I'm gonna see if I can maybe try out a different medication and talk to her and have a conversation. Like, I don't know, I might talk to her about like maybe still having the Lexapro, but also trying something else. So that way, and here's something for all of you out there who struggle with mental illness, like I do. Like, I try to set up safeguards. So like, let's say she prescribes me a new medication, but it doesn't work. At least I have my old medication still so I can turn back to that, so I don't freak out and lose my mind and run into a situation like I did over the weekend. You know what I mean? So I'm gonna have an open conversation with her. As an addict in recovery, I have to, you know, remind her and tell her like, hey, we gotta make sure it's a non-narcotic and things like that, so I can try something new, something different. But anyways, I might do some updates. I don't know what she'll prescribe for me or what I can take and things like that. But yeah, like mainly with the Lexapro side effects, I don't know. It's weird because I was talking to my friend on my live stream today, and I don't know, sometimes I feel like I don't have emotions, but maybe it's just, it's hard to explain. I could do a whole nother video on this. Do I not have emotions, or am I just more sane now so things don't get me as emotionally charged anymore like they used to? Like, I talk about how I can relate to a lot of symptoms of like things like borderline personality disorder from back in the day, because I used to just have extreme emotions, but that doesn't really happen anymore. So I don't know if that's the medications or if it's because I'm more mentally stable. I don't know, I'm a weirdo. Like, sometimes I ask myself, like, do you just want to go crazy again, Chris? Like, do you like being in that chaos? Because that's something else we struggle with. Anyways, that's all I got, that's all I got. So yeah, if you can relate to that, like, let me know down in the comments if you can relate to not wanting to take medications. Like, is it your pride? Is it your ego? Is it, I shouldn't have to do this, da-da-da-da-da. Like, let me know down in the comments, partially so I know that I'm not alone in feeling like this, all right? But that's all I got for you with this video. Come over, join me over on Twitch in the live stream. It's linked down in the description below, all right? Come keep me company. I'm gonna be on there for the rest of this evening, and I stream, like, pretty much once a day, all right? But if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, and if you are new here, I'm always making videos to help you out with your mental and emotional well-being. Click that subscribe button and ring that notification bell. And a huge thank you to everybody supporting the channel over on Patreon. You are all amazing. And for all of you watching, if you want to get yourself some sweet Rewired Soul merch, click or tap on that icon right there. All right, thanks so much for watching. Take your meds, and I'll see you next time.